When June awoke in the morning, it was late. She knew by the light in the room and the position of the sun that she had not woken early as she usually did. She looked over at the other bed to see if Josie were still sleeping, but saw her bed empty, neatly made with all the sheets and blankets tucked, as per the program's policy. June sat up and looked around. The room was quiet and still. Far too quiet for her. It gave her the creeps, made her worry about what was going on that she didn't know about. Though Josie had just left for breakfast or to get some fresh air without her, she felt like the girl had abandoned her. She was all alone in the jail cell when Josie was supposed to be there to help her through it. She slid her feet out of bed and stood up. When she opened the door, she did so quietly, slowly and quietly, so that no one would hear if they were standing nearby. As quietly as she could, she peeked around the door, ears pricked for Josie's voice. Had she just gone off and left June? They were supposed to be roommates, the J twins, Josie had called them, though the moniker reminded June too much of her real twin and how he had disappeared from her life. If she and Josie were supposed to be twins, then they were supposed to be together, to stay together and support each other. There was no sign of Josie. June slipped into the hallway and listened, but couldn't hear her. June walked to the cafeteria, expecting to find Josie there. Maybe she was just extra hungry. Maybe she thought that June was too tired, or was planning to bring something back to her. Maybe she was saving a place for June, though June knew that the program wasn't full and there would be empty seats. Her eye caught on a small knot of people as she walked by the common room. June stopped and looked in their direction to see what was going on. Josie was one of them. Her head close to the others, her voice a whisper, as they carried on a conversation that June had not been invited to join. What was all that about? Did she have something to hide from June? Were they talking about June behind her back, mocking her for being different and for having flashbacks? It wasn't like June could help it. She would have given just about anything to live a normal life like everyone else did. She wished she knew what was being said so she would know for sure. As it was, she backed away and went to the cafeteria. She would show Josie that she didn't care about their little clique. She didn't care what they were saying about her or how they despised her. They could say whatever they wanted. She would go on with her life and not care one bit about them. She went through the breakfast line, having a small plate of the scrambled eggs and sprinkling cheese over them, and a cup of coffee. She'd started to feel hungry again, which Mary said was because of the methadone treatment, so she actually felt like eating some mornings. But the food that the program got was crappy. June liked sweets for breakfast, muffins or donuts or other pastries. She despised oatmeal, cold cereal unless it was one of the kiddie sugar cereals like Lucky Charms, and couldn't abide most fruits by themselves, though she tolerated them in the fruit filling of a donut or pie. The recovery program didn't carry anything like that, so June settled for the scrambled eggs, plain, not with any little bits of vegetables chopped into them, and the coffee. It was a while before Josie entered the cafeteria. Whatever she'd been discussing with her little group of friends must have taken a good deal of time. She looked around and waved at June, but June stared straight ahead, pretending not even to see her. Josie tried again, and June continued to ignore her. Eventually, Josie went through the breakfast line herself, loading up on eggs and toast and orange juice, and brought her plate over to the table where June was sitting. "Hey, girl, you were tired this morning. Didn't even stir when I tried to wake you up." June ignored her. Josie settled in across from her without appearing to notice the slight. She set down her plate and swirled the orange juice in the cup as she looked down at it. "Pulp. I don't like the pulpy kind of juice, do you? I know it's supposed to be good for you, but I would think that straining out the little bits wouldn't be all that bad. It still has the same amount of vitamins, right?" June said nothing, looking down at her eggs and slowly chewing the bite in her mouth. "Sometimes I like to pretend it's another dose of methadone," Josie said with a laugh, still swirling the orange juice in the glass. She looked across the table at June and finally frowned, cluing in to the fact that June was freezing her out. "Hey, what's wrong?" June glared at her, then looked down at her eggs again. "Seriously," Josie complained. "If I did something to bug you, tell me. I hate the silent treatment." Which only encouraged June more to do it. She didn't say a word. "June, what? Are you offended by my talk about pulp in orange juice? What did I do to you? I didn't do anything." June continued to shovel eggs into her mouth until they were gone, then pushed the plate away from her. She left it on the table and got up and headed for the door. She knew very well that they were supposed to clear their own dishes and not leave anything on the table, but she didn't care. Let someone else clean up after her for once. Why did she have to be the mother? June! Josie called after her, frustrated. Josie's call attracted the attention of the staff, and someone noticed that June had not cleared her dish. You should know better, one of the kitchen staff said. Grab your dish and put it in one of the tubs. June looked at her and continued to walk away. June, you come back here and do what you're told. June headed for the door, but the increased attention meant that one of the security staff, who kept a low-key presence in the recovery program, noticed the problem, and she moved over to block June's exit. Go back and clear your plate, she told June. I'm not doing it today, June snapped. She tried to blow past the woman but didn't succeed. The CO moved to block her, spreading her arms and legs apart to fill the doorway and not allow June passage. You need to follow the rules. Go on back and clear your place, or I'll have to put you on report. June would have fewer privileges and more chores if she got put on report. She didn't want to have to do a bunch of extra crap that the staff should have been doing. They were the ones who got paid for it, not June. She wasn't anybody's slave. She tried to shove her way past. Let me out! You can't keep me in here! I certainly can, and I will until you do what you're told. What do you think this is? National June Day? You're not special. Clear your place. You're not special. The words stung. June knew she wasn't anybody. She hadn't ever achieved anything significant, not even an award in school, and she never would. She hadn't been an outstanding mother. She hadn't been able to stay sober. She hadn't been able to keep Justin. Everything she touched had turned to dust. She hit the CO in the chest, square on, a straight right, hard enough to knock the wind out of her and make her take a couple of steps back to regain her footing. June followed, trying to get out of the room before the woman could manage to recover, but others had seen the scuffle and were converging on her. Josie was still sitting at the table, her mouth wide open, when June whirled around to face the staff who were approaching her from behind. "Leave me the hell alone!" "What's wrong, June?" Mary Bennett asked, with that long-suffering tone she often had. She would have made a good mother, with that fake martyr attitude. Like something that June had done was the cause of Mary being stuck there in a secure recovery treatment program. That wasn't June's fault. Mary was the one who'd gotten herself into that one, and she was the one who would have to fix it if that wasn't where she wanted to be. It wasn't June's fault. "You need to calm down. Did something happen to bother you?" "Nothing happened," June said. "I'm just tired of being ordered around like a slave around here. Nobody's paying me to clean up. Why do I have to do your job?" "My job? Come on, June. Everybody helps around here. You show us that you can be a mature and responsible person, that you're taking your recovery seriously, so we can make recommendations to the court when your case comes up. If we can say that you've done well here, the chances are the judge will go a lot easier on you." June just swore at her. "Somebody got up on the wrong side of the bed this morning," Josie observed in a low voice, just loud enough for June to be able to hear the words. June turned towards her, fists coming up without any conscious thought. "You were supposed to be my friend. That's what you said from the start, that we were like twins. A twin wouldn't treat me the way you did. My twin would never have treated me like that." Even though her twin had treated her exactly like that. Her twin had abandoned her, even worse than Josie had. He'd left her alone, without even the children to keep her company, and told her that he was never coming back. How could a person who had claimed to love her do that? "You're nuts," Josie told her. "We're roomies, and I don't know what the heck I did to tick you off. Maybe it's your time of the month, but don't act like we're best friends or something. I'm not even sure I like you at this point." June surged forward to fight Josie, fury rising up in her like a pressure cooker with the valve released. Josie was talking behind her back, was challenging her in front of everyone else, and admitted that she didn't even like June. Josie had been leading her on ever since June had been admitted, pretending to be a friend when she was nothing of the sort. June flew at Josie, spitting and landing her second blow of the day, a punch to the face that toppled Josie like a tree. June landed on top of her, not willing to let it go at that. She wasn't going to let Josie badmouth her when she hadn't done anything wrong.